Well, hello, hello, hello. My name is Bianca. Welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome back if you are returning. In this video, we're going to be tackling my Hannah Carlson collection. Again, these videos are for my purposes. I want to take an inventory of the titles that I have and what I've actually done with them and share that with you. Hopefully, as we're going along, some of the titles, you'll find something that interests you and may, you know, sparks your curiosity, and maybe you want to add it to your collection. Or if you had been curious about a title, maybe this will help you decide against it. So it could go either way depending on everyone's personal taste. I will say that I do like Hannah Carlson very much. She's very popular in the adult coloring community. And there's no denying that she has a wonderful imagination. And I do have favorite titles of hers, for sure. So, without further ado, we're just going to get into it. I don't really have that many titles, at least I don't think. This is not by any means... Actually, let me not say that because I really don't know. These are the titles that I have, but I honestly don't know if these are all of the titles that she's put out. Because Amazon doesn't... I've noticed as I'm purchasing, like, Rita Berman. I think she's a German artist, if I'm not mistaken. Amazon does carry her titles, but I don't think I have access to everything. And it's the same with Hannah Carlson. She is, I believe, a Swedish artist. And when she releases a title, I think she releases it, of course, in her country first, and it's in her language and so forth. And I honestly don't know if I have every single title that she's ever put out. There are several different editions. For example, I know that I don't have all of these, like, illustrated little coloring books of hers, because I believe that the ones that come in this format were originally released as part of a restaurant chain of restaurants, where pages were passed out on the tables for the children to color in. If I'm not mistaken, I think that's what these were about. And of those, I only have these two. All right, so for Summer Nights, I have two copies because I messed up this page so badly, at least in my mind, that I felt like, and this was last year early, I think maybe April, or I mean, let me see here. When did I start? I felt like I had messed up this page so badly that I totally ruined the book for myself. So I purchased an additional copy just to attempt this page again, this double spread. And I completed it in the new copy. And this is the color scheme that I ended up with, which is a little bit brighter. And for me, maybe a little safe, but I'm not displeased with it. It gives me kind of 1970s vibes with, the color scheme that I chose. Definitely. Now that I look at it, it's like 1970s. So this is I think the only page I've completed in this duplicate that I have in my collection, and I did this in June of 23. So definitely I was attempting that double page maybe in May, if I'm not mistaken. And I felt that, like, I had ruined it, the book, with the acrylic background. I went back and tried, you know, these are Posca's right here. I believe this is Castle Arts pencils. And just regular acrylic, black acrylic for the background, because I don't even remember what the colors was that I had in here, but it was turning out so hideous. Like, it really went so sideways that I used acrylic black to, or black acrylic paint to just get rid of it. And then I used Posca's to do like the multi stars. I'm not sure if it's showing all that well, but I did different colors that kind of match the feather tones with it. There's some reds, some greens, some oranges, some yellows, and so forth to do kind of like the Starry Night. It looks really nice, but I'm still stumped as to what to do for the rest of it. At some point, I'm going to figure it out and complete this page as well, now that I'm not so green and that I understand now that it's okay to use different mediums on a page. When I first started out, I believe this attempt was in May, because I completed this one in June. And of course, I started coloring in April. So I was really nervous, and I wanted to get things right and just putting all kinds of pressure on myself that it's really not necessary. But you know, when you start something new, you kind of sweat it a little more. You want to be correct in your attempts. And when you're doing any kind of creative work, you know, that can't be a thing. So I now have two copies of Summer Nights. I'm not mad at it, but I do. So I decided to get over myself along, you know, in regards to this issue, and continue coloring in this particular book instead of continuing in this one. So this is the book that has my very lovely lizard. And this was almost a fail as well, but I decided to push on, and I'm not unhappy with the results. This was completed in February of this year, 2024, but I actually began this page way back in the day in 2023. I just abandoned it. I figured this would be the book that I would make all of my mistakes on. And it's turning out to be that way, but also I'm correcting my mistakes in it as well. So this one is, this is a March completed page, and I featured this page already on the channel. So yeah, I think in this, so basically what I'm going to do is I'm just going to count these two as one, but I'm not going to count the pages in here other than that double spread. So I don't think I have much to, you know, I've colored much in this book. So let's take a quick look this way. If you've never seen this book, which for those of you who are beginners, you probably haven't. And you get give you a quick feel for Hannah Carlson's line work and her artistry, and why she's so popular with so many different colorists here on the platform. She just does beautiful things, and the paper is just absolutely wonderful. She's one of my favorites. Definitely up there. She's got like that top placement. And if I had to list my favorite line illustrators, she's occupies the same spot as Kirby and Johanna Basford. She's very witty. Her line work is very, very thick, I think. It's consistent throughout. It doesn't really change very much from element to element. And everything she does is just her. I mean, I would love to live in her head for one day when she's dreaming up these things. What a rich dream life she has, you know? It's just fabulous. She's just has such a spectacular dream life, and she's able to put it on paper to the delight of the world. I think she's a treasure, really. My goodness, I just utterly enjoyed just looking at the things that she's drawn. so fabulous. I would like to attempt this one next, but I haven't made any plans for April. I have done a few. I've completed a few pages for April, so I am pushing myself to color and enjoy my collection. I'm pushing myself, but in a good way. I'm not pushing myself like out of obligation or anything like that. I truly, truly would want to not fall away. It's getting to the point where it's becoming a habit, a good habit, because it's really relaxing. I mean, I truly enjoy this hobby. I hope that those of you who are new, who just found my channel, hi. Thank you for being here and for spending some of your very precious time with my antics. I hope that some of my tips and tricks can steer you in the right direction. I'm also a beginner. April is my anniversary year. It's my birthday month and my anniversary year, 1 year in the coloring hobby. So bear with me. We're going to be learning together, making mistakes together, and hopefully having fun. All right, so I do have Summer Nights duplicate copies. So I've done quite a bit, and in the duplicate copy, I know I only have that one double page spread. Let's take a quick look at it again. As much as I like it, I'm not sure that I'm going to repeat this color story. Watch me now repeat this color story and everything else that I color. I also have this one. This one is Grains of Gold. And I think this was a compilation. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I think this is the only compilation book in her collection of titles, if I'm not mistaken. And it's called Grains of Gold. And here it says 11 new drawings plus 83 favorites. So I honestly think, and I haven't done anything in this book. Let me take a quick look at it. So let's see here real quick. This is City Amongst the Stars, and I really, really love this title. Oh, sorry. So much so that I might actually pick up a duplicate of this one. I just want to see if I'm right. I'm a sci-fi nerd, so I grew up on Star Wars, Star Trek, and Stargate, plus Arthur C. Clarke and the classic writers when I was a child. That was just like the thing for me. So this theme, this is a whip that I'm doing this month. So this theme is absolutely up my alley, that I'm thinking that might actually be in here, unless it's one of the new 11. Drawings that I completed that one in this book. So this is the one completed page I have in this book, plus the whip that I'm working on this month. Hopefully I'll get it completed in April. Oh, it is. Okay, so this might be a new one. It looks like it belongs in the City Amongst the Stars, right? It does. Okay. Let's take another look here. So now we're going from Space Age to Viking Age. This I've seen somewhere else. So that's not a new one. That's a favorite. Oh, wow. Look at this bunny. I think this is in another book as well. Look at that frog. That's amazing. Some of these I recognize. I think this... The Witch's Cottage. It's not in Atlantis. I wonder if it might be in Seasons. I'm not sure. I've seen this before. This one I've also seen before. And this one I've definitely seen before. I think this... Am I missing a book? Let me see. I wonder if that's in Seasons. So Seasons is another one that is a favorite. This is actually the first Hannah Carlson book that I ever purchased, was Seasons. Jen's Coloring Corner has a color along on her channel for this page. I think she's attempting to fully color this book. And I think I may get another copy of it and go through all of her color alongs and do them as she did them. Because believe it or not, I love the way her color palette is. Not intuitive to me, but man, is it super exciting. She's done this one recently as well. Here are the little chickies that I've done, I think. Okay, so I've got one page colored in this one. I apologize if I'm going all over the place, but I'm trying to figure out if I'm not crazy. Am I crazy or am I not? Oh, I do have a completed page. Oh, this is the one with the Himmy. I finally completed it. You'll probably be seeing this page again at the end in this month's compilation. So I finally completed this page. That was my test page or my... She's done this one on her channel too. I really would like to do that. 2, 3. Beautiful. Oh, I've completed this one as well. So I've done quite a bit in this book, which I truly, truly love. This one and City Amongst the Stars might be my two most favorites. Huh. Okay, so it's not in Seasons. Anyway, that was Seasons. I wonder if this is in, like, it might be in Spirit Animals, if I'm not mistaken. Either Daydreams or Spirit Animals. Anyway, so this one is definitely in another book. In this one, this is the one that I completed in Seasons. Was it Seasons? I do things and I don't know what I do. Summer Nights. That's the same spread in Summer Nights. Isn't it? Yes, it is. Oh, awesome. I have now two additional attempts to explore different color palettes with this one. Yay. That's the fun part. And you have a chance to do other image, you know, the same picture again. Just saw this one as well. So this book is definitely a compilation of favorites. So it's worth getting if you want to try coloring beloved illustrations in different color palettes. It just gives you a chance to do it over and to experiment with different color combinations. Oh, this is nice. That's a nice double spread. And I just did this one too. I can do this one other colors. That's fun. This is in seasons. Oh. Awesome. Here is the double spread that Jen did on her channel. Cool. Oh, I wanted to try this one again. Here it is. Okay, wonderful. Wonderful. So you're starting to see her. She's very consistent from title to title as far as her line work and her style. You just like Kirby Rosan is, you can definitely and Johanna Basford and even RJ Hampson, they have specific styles that are readily recognizable. I think this might be in Spirit Animals as well. Okay. Very cool. This might be a new one. I have not seen this in the other titles. This is cute. This looks more modern, right? This one and this one are kind of a bit of a departure as far as they're way more simpler for Hannah Carlson. So cool, so cool. And I think this is Spirit Animals as well. All right, so this is a nice compilation book of different titles. It's called Grains of Gold. That highly recommend. Nothing done in here yet, but we're going to get to it. All righty, so Magical Dawn. Have I done anything in this one? Yes, I have. I completed this one with Kalor Pencils. And this was done last month. All right, so not bad, not bad. I'll tell you that when I'm coloring in Hannah Carlson's books, I really do leave this world. You know what I mean? They're so relaxing. And it's intricate enough, you know, like it's not a mythographic. It's not a Fabiana Attanasio type of mythographic. But they're intricate enough, but you can make out the elements one from the other. You understand what I'm saying? She draws in a way where your eyes can actually focus on one element at a time. Even when there are things in front and behind and perspective and things like that, it's easy. You know that this is going to be a fun time. This is nice. Look how it seems like it's complicated, but it's workable, it's doable. The elements are very distinct. Here we have stars. We have butterflies, a couple of insects. Sorry. Sorry. I had to replace the battery. But like I was saying, it's very different, this type of busy illustration versus one of Fabiana Attanasio's in the mythographic line. Again, I find Fabiana in her mythographic line to be very, very challenging. So, and that's not a bad thing. It's okay. But I do have to be like mentally prepared so that I don't allow myself to be frustrated too easily with it. I think for this type of like endeavor, when we're trying to color for stress relief, it could be risky when you're tackling something that Fabiana has done, because you might get frustrated. So she forces you to think out of the box. And after 12, 13, 14 hours at work, I don't want to. I have to be in the mood. But you know, I've already done a few pages in her coloring book, so obviously it's doable. But her titles in the Mythographic line are absolutely vacation, when you're on vacation. So that you don't have an excuse not to complete it. I think this one is in Grain of Gold as well. Very cool. So that's Magical Dawn, and I only have the one page in, completed in it. As much as I love Hannah Carlson, I'm not doing so well. But then again, it's only 1 year into the hobby, so let's relax. All right, so this one is Daydreams. And I don't know that, I know I have something done in here, but I don't know if this is a compilation book as well. Or if it's a standalone original theme. Oh wow, look at these owls. How cute is that? This is also adorable. Oh, here's that one that I was trying to find. I know I had seen it somewhere else, I just didn't realize it was in this one. Now, like, the covers kind of throw me off. Some of these covers kind of have their own theme as well. This one's a little different. You see how this side, these sizes kind of have their own theme? This one, out of all of them, is the one that's kind of, yeah, kind of its own thing. So I don't know if it's a compilation or not. Okay, so I only have one page completed in this book. And this is, I think, the first time I've noticed that she has given us an option to draw our own things in. I know that Kirby has several titles in his line where you can draw things in, but this is, I think, the only one that I've seen that has that she's given us that option. So these are the bees. This was completed last month. Wow, look at this peacock. Oops. Oh, wow. Just wow. This one has a lot more flowers. Oh, here's the double page friends. This one has a lot more flowers and birds and critters than what I've seen so far. Yep, here's that one too. Not mad at it. This is a beautiful, beautiful. Everything she does is beautiful. Look at those jellyfish. And seahorses. That's nice. Isn't this in some other book? This might be a compilation book as well. It might be. I'll have to research and find out. If you happen to know, please leave a comment. Here's one that looks like it belongs in City Amongst the Stars. But this might be a compilation book. Here's this rabbit again. Yeah, it might be. All right, I'm not mad at that either. More chances to do it. Here's another one that's very popular. I forgot who's, because of course I did. But I think it was My Colorful Country Life. She had this. She has, I think, a double. If correct me if I'm wrong. But I think she has a page. I don't think it was this one. Spirit Animals. I think. It was a double page, but I think it's towards the back of the book. This one's really nice. It really is, because it's kind of like, of course, like the title suggests, spirit animals, but it's more on the theme of like your totem animals. Think for those of you who are still Harry Potter fans, like your Patronus. This is nice. The animal that you're most closest to. Oh, here it is. Here's this again. Okay. She did such a beautiful job. Medusa. Who doesn't love Medusa? I love Medusa. I think it's towards the back of the book. That's it. Those were repeats also. So there's some crossover from title to title. It's not so bad. That's really pretty. I like that. I think it's towards the back of the book. Where is it? We've seen these two already. This one. This one is in, I believe, My Colorful Country Life. She's got a color along for this one where she did it in like blues. Beautiful. She did such a beautiful job. That it's just mesmerizing to watch her color this double page. But I believe it was My Colorful Country Life. So I'm going to look into that because this might be a project. This might be a good color along for me to do. Like, you know, off camera. Follow her color scheme. Sometimes you have to follow other folks' color schemes as they're doing it while you know, when you're starting, just so that you can get a feel of how the colors work together, and then you just branch off from there on other pages. You know what I mean? So don't be afraid to do color alongs for other you know, that other folks are putting on the platform, because it does help. Here is Jewelry Box. And let's see what we're in for this one. Oh, thank you. Oh, that's so cute. That's a nice page. I like that she has not just animals and flowers and things like that, but that she actually has really interesting folks. Like, her characters are so unique and they're easy to color, and I don't mean easy like I don't know, I don't find myself being intimidated. Once all I have to do is pick the color scheme that I really want to do this in. That I think is the hardest part with Hannah Carlson's, is like, okay, what color schemes? What colors do I pick? And then once you've got that figured out, you're off to the races with her line work. It's so intimate in a way. I don't have anything colored in this book. I know that for a fact. So I don't even know why I'm giving you, well, let's give you a quick flip through. Ooh. Wow. This is good to flip. Oh my gosh. Shelly, I think, did this page on her channel as well. And she did it in like greens, like she did it natural colors, and it is spectacular the way she tackled this. I think it's Coloring with Shell or Shell Colors or something like that. If I find the channels, I'll put it down. But anyway, this is somewhere on the platform by somebody, and they did a beautiful job. You get inspired by other folks, you really do. So now I know where that page is at, because once, if I find that video again, I'm gonna want to do it too. She also did Penguins by Kirby Rosanis. She did a beautiful job on that double spread. It's amazing. But do you see what I mean by her folks? By the characters that she creates? They're dreamy, and they're also, it's like they're in two different worlds, you know? She puts like these little tattoos on them, which is such a modern thing. And yet, the type of clothing that they have could be like from centuries past, like Victorian-ish. I mean, she knows how to merge different styles together to create like a theme that's just like, I want to live there. I love it. I love what she does. She doesn't do that many dogs. But when she does a dog, it's comical. This is beautiful as well. And I don't have anything colored in this one. Oh, that's a shame, because it's such a beautiful, beautiful book. I need to get on it. And of the smaller ones, we've already seen City Amongst the Stars, which is my favorite in this size. The next favorite in this size for me is Forest Kingdom. And I think I have done a few in here, or at least one. Oh, wow. Have I not colored anything in here? Or am I crazy? Let's see. Her frogs are so cute and comical and whimsy and all of the above. Yes. Yes, I did. All right. This I did when? This was in July. And I based this one off of a ladybug. And this was done with Prismacolor pencils, Posca, and probably Winsor & Newton watercolors. I had a small set of Winsor & Newton's, and I think I used those on the background. So I think I only have one color page in this book. But this one's a tale of, you know, this really is foresty. Even the people, Tinkerbell-like, and mushroom homes. This is a cute one right here. Oh, nice. And Titania, Shakespeare's fairy queen. This is really nice. Yeah, I only have one in this one. Oh, that's a shame. Okay. Well, we're trying to get on it. I don't think I've colored anything in Masquerade. And this is a fun one for, like, Halloween. It's supposed to be, like, Masquerade, like, costume ball theming. But that works for Halloween as well. Halloween doesn't necessarily need to be all witches and vampires. It could be something like this too, I think. I don't have anything colored in Masquerade, I'm almost certain. I'm gonna need to pick something in here and do it. This one actually has more people characters in it and more animal characters in it than it has flowers and things like that. It's got a mix of two things. There's more people in this title than in any of the other ones that she has, in my opinion. Way more. This is a cute spread right there. So yeah, so if you like Hannah Carlson's, how she draws folks, people, instead of like more nature driven, Midnight Masquerade might be the title for you. And in A Witch's Cottage, which is also, I like them all. Come on, I like them all. But I do like this theming, because I love Halloween. Is one of my favorite holidays, or unofficial holidays. This one definitely lives up to its theme. with everything in it. And I have this one done, which this was done with Cool Bank, the 180 set in October of 23. Really? So I did something in those 4 months. Okay. I did this. I didn't even remember. And I think I did. Oh, was this something that I picked to do? Oh yeah, this is something that I picked to do. Not that I have it done. All right. And I totally forgot. Obviously, it didn't get done. But I did this in October. I didn't think I had colored anything in the last 4 months of 23. Whoops. We'll have to change that. I think Zucchini Kitty has a color along for this page on her channel. A two-part color along for that. Zucchini Kitty tackles Hannah Carlson. I think she also has this in a very spectacular way. Her color stories are amazing. So I think I have only 2 pages done in this book. That's not too bad considering where I'm at so far. And then this is, of course, Tales from Atlantis. I do have a completed page in this book for this month. So this is the most recent release, and I truly love it as much as I love The Witch's Cottage. And yeah, it is the most recent release, and I've already completed a page in here. So I am tackling Hannah Carlson. I'm just not focusing on a book, you know what I mean? Completely. I'm just doing different pages in different books. But I don't want to show it because that's a March completion. And I will show that one at the end of the month. Alrighty. So then for her, for this particular illustrator, I have these two. Again, these I think were like supposed to be children's coloring books. But it doesn't matter. They just happen to be done bigger. They're a little bit more simpler. We have food themings here. It's something that it really attracts the children because I think that was the intent to begin with. These were passed out in her native country in several restaurants. There's a story behind these. I don't know all of the details, but there are other titles other than these. It's just that I think this one is the most recent one. Let me see. Do we have any information? Yeah, this was 2023. This was also 2023. But these, I think, are the only two at the time when I was shopping on Amazon that came up that I didn't readily recognize that they were Hannah Carlson. But they are. And I think this title specifically I had seen but didn't realize it was Hannah until I saw, I think maybe it was an Instagram reel or something like that. Somebody featured this book, and then I went on to Amazon and I got it, and I think these were the only two that were available at the time. I'll have to hunt to see if other titles in this particular children's line of coloring books is available. Because it's quintessential Hannah Carlson for sure. And it threatens to be a little bit kawaii-ish for her. The line work is definitely simpler and a lot more goofy. Which I'm loving it. I'm here for it. This is really talking to my inner child. This looks like it's a lot of fun. Yeah, this one's my favorite from these little books. Okay, so that's it that's what I have for Hannah Carlson. Again, just like my RJ Hampson collection of books, I've done pages here and there, but I haven't really tackled any one title in a significant way, and I really need to get to it. So this year also, we're going to be trying to do more pages in all of these collections. But we're, you know, also going to take it easy, because as you can see, anybody else I think would be overwhelmed with the amount of coloring books that I have thus far, just in those three collections, which is the Mythographic, which is a huge collection on my shelves. RJ Hampson for sure. RJ Hampson is a smaller collection, but he has a lot in those books, you know, a lot of intricate designs that you color, especially Mr. Fogarty's. The two Mr. Fogarty coloring books are just, you know, a place where you can get yourself lost in. And I also here for it. So I'm want to tackle these three collections this year the most, I think. I have Johanna Basford, a few from her, and Kirby as well. But I think these are the three illustrators that I would like to see myself have more pages completed than the rest of my collection. I have a few from Maria Troll, a few from Mel Pomeni, and a few from Kirby, as well as Denise Klett. But we're going to start working on these first. So in my channel, you're probably going to see a lot of completed pages from these three collections for this year, and I hope you're here for it. Of course, I am going to color in my other books as well, here and there, for sure. Like Mel Pomeni, I'm really doing a lot on hers as well, in addition to me wanting to tackle some of these before we get other titles released that I have to add, that, you know, again, two hands and not enough hours to get to everything that I would like to in these books. But she is a lot of fun, and I do highly recommend Hannah Carlson, especially for beginners. Probably her more than anything else. Her and Kirby, and you know, a lot of folks gravitate towards Johanna Basford. And because her line work appears to be simple, but once you start coloring in it, you realize it's like, it's an undertaking. It's fun. It's not bad. It's not a chore by any means, but her illustrations do have a lot of details in them. It just kind of blindsides you a little bit how much detail she has on any one of her illustrations, versus Hannah Carlson, which could kind of, like, on the surface seem very, very complicated to color. And then when you start doing it, it's like, oh, this was, you know, you just smoothly go through it. And that's been my experience, when comparing Hannah Carlson to Johanna Basford. Both are wonderful. Both are worth your time and your money and your, like, personal investment. So that's not the issue. It's just like, what would you be in the mood for, and what kind of experience would you have when you're coloring it in their books, you know, for their line works. So that's it. It's a sad, sad state, my little collection. I don't have as many pages as I thought I did, and I'm going to need to get on that. So until the next video, guys, I hope you're staying safe and keep on coloring. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.